Hi, my name is Charlie Teo. I'm a professor of neurosurgery, currently with appointments on several continents actually, mostly working in Spain as a neurosurgeon, but also China and many other developing countries. My practice was solely in Australia at one stage, but I've sort of branched out now. And I really felt that there was a need to raise money for brain cancer research from a very early age. I started several other foundations to raise money for brain cancer research, and the Charlie Teo Foundation was founded in 2017. Its sole purpose is to increase awareness of brain cancer and to increase funding for brain cancer research. Well, most people don't realise the impact that brain cancer has on society. It is ranked number one in terms of PYLs, or person years lost. It has a huge impact on society in terms of socioeconomic and emotional. It is poorly funded, despite those figures. In fact, it's the most common cancer to kill young adults less than the age of 39, 40, and it's the most common cancer to kill children. It affects all races, all ages, all genders. And therefore, we don't concentrate on one particular subgroup of people, we concentrate on the tumour itself. The incidence of brain cancer is such that about 1,500 to 2,000 patients will be diagnosed with brain cancer per year. That means the incidence is somewhere between 7 and 8 cases per 100,000 population in OECD countries. And like I say, unfortunately, it affects young people and it is the most common solid cancer in children. And yet with those statistics, it is the least funded. The aim of the Charlie Teo Foundation was to raise money for much needed research into this terrible disease. We have ensured that the mantra of the Charlie Teo Foundation includes a foundation that runs very lean. In other words, keeping our overhead costs low. Specific aim of the foundation is to try and find scientists that are disruptive, who think outside the box, once we identify those researchers, to support them. And finally, to be incredibly transparent, unfortunately, a lot of large charities hide their costs by fudging their figures. We don't believe in that, and we like being incredibly transparent about our overheads, our costs, and how much money actually goes to research. By way of transparency, I am not a scientist, I'm a clinician. I don't even speak the language of the scientist, but I strongly believe that the answer to brain cancer is in the lab, not in the operating room. With that philosophy, I've taken it upon myself to raise money for our scientists who are struggling to keep up their research projects. I have determined that there are many good scientists out there who are very disruptive thinkers who unfortunately are poorly funded. And my job is to identify those researchers and to fund them. Brain cancer, unfortunately, has not made too many advances in the last 50 years. People are still dying very rapidly. In fact, the mean survival once you're diagnosed with brain cancer is somewhere between 8 and 18 months. And that really hasn't changed much. Because of that, I think it's incredibly important just to focus on the research. And as such, we've committed almost $15 million to brain cancer research since the founding of the foundation in 2017. We're funding two very large projects, one in America and one in Australia. The one in Australia is collaborating with a research team that specializes in single-cell genomics, in particular RNA sequencing, and that project is going very, very well. In fact, they had very few brain cancer patients and data before we joined them, and now we're pleased to say that the project has a huge number of specimens from our tumour bank that they've examined and are producing good data from that. The study we're funding in the United States is really very interesting. It turns out that patients with GBM, or the worst type of brain cancer, actually have an immunocompromised state. Their CD4 cell circulating cell count is almost as low as some with HIV/AIDS. It's very, very low. Where are those cells? They're stuck in the bone marrow. Now, CD4 cells normally have some sort of exit visa to get out of the bone marrow. it turns out that GBM patients, CD4 cells, don't have that visa. If we can find why they don't have the visa, then of course we can get them out of the bone marrow so that they can do their job, and that is attack the brain tumour. Animal studies done on this very same concept has shown that if you give animals an agent to bring those CD4 cells out of the bone marrow, their survival will be longer. So good animal studies, good background, and we're hoping now, of course, to translate that into the human studies. You know, the Charlie Teo Foundation is in a pretty unique position to find and fund those out-of-the-box thinkers. I would consider myself a global neurosurgeon. I'm traveling almost every, 3 out of 4 weeks. I practice neurosurgery in many different continents, and I speak to all the scientists in those universities who are doing brain cancer research. That's a huge resource. I can really put my finger on the pulse as to what projects are going on where and how good those projects are. Furthermore, even though our foundation runs lean, we felt one of the most important people to have as part of our foundation was a scientific officer who can comb the internet, comb publications, comb journals, and find these good projects that need funding. I'm very proud to say that we've used every means possible to find those people, including social media, LinkedIn, Instagram, TikTok, to find these out-of-the-box thinkers. Look, another part of the foundation of which I'm very proud is the fact that we've broken down geopolitical barriers. And I guess what I mean by that is that sadly, politics affects a lot of decisions. And I didn't want that to happen when it came to brain cancer. Our mantra was to find the brightest minds. And those brightest minds may not necessarily be studying brain cancer currently, but if they're doing something that we feel may help our field, then of course we find them. In the last 7 years, since 2017, we have funded scientists in America, Australia, UK, Spain, many other different countries. Of course, they have to be concentrating or align with our philosophy that brain cancer is a terrible cancer based on several major reasons. One major reason is its heterogeneity. Another reason is the fact that it's protected by the blood-brain barrier. And it's these concepts that we feel should be concentrated on when we find these scientists.